Hello, puggies, and welcome to the Pug Life Show, brought to you by Pug Parties, because your pug deserves to be the best dressed pug at a party, and you can check out their outfits at pugparties.com. I'm your host, Donna, and with me are my puggy co-hosts, Charles and Rosie. This week, our guests are Claire and her puggies, Teddy and Doug. This is an episode with a difference, because you're going to be serenaded by a singing puggy. That's right. It's a first for the show, and I can't wait for you to hear the repertoire. Plus, Claire shares with us what she thinks Doug and Teddy smell like and what naughty little things they both get up to. I think you'll enjoy kind of empathise with some of these stories. I do want to mention that this episode was recorded as part of our live stream series. So if you want to watch the show, then please use the link in the show notes to watch the replay. And before we start, I want to remind you to subscribe to our newsletter in the show notes so you get advance notice of our next episode and much, much more.
Evening, whatever it is. Evening.
Yes, evening for us, morning for you because you're in the UK.
So we've got Doug.
Are
you going to turn around, Doug?
Oh, come on, puppy. So that's Doug, isn't it?
Not yet. No, he said no. And the one that's asleep is the singing one.
Of course. He's getting his vocal cords ready.
He's just relaxing. As soon as the songs come on, he'll perk up and stand. Of course. I hope, fingers crossed.
I'll pop up a few people who are saying hello. So hello from Lynn, who's her pugs are Gerald and Oscar, and I know them quite well. And hello to Kim and Tonka. They're looking forward to tonight, as of course we all are, because once Teddy's ready to go, obviously got to be ready to go. Oh, and apparently go the All Blacks. Is there like a rugby game on this weekend as well? I think there's too many. It's the end of the year, so there's loads of grand finals. Now, remember, Claire, you were saying that you don't follow Aussie rules football, but you do follow Aussie rugby.
Yeah.
And you, what was it, Parramatta?
Parramatta, yeah, Parramatta. Yeah.
That's unfortunately, they're not in the grand final.
No.
I was going to say, if I remember, it's the Penrith Panthers, and I can't. Oh, and I think it's the Roosters, if I remember correctly. I'm sure somebody will correct me. That's for sure. So hello to Jackie. So Jackie's actually my cousin from Tassie, and Harry. Oh wow, you've got like the whole crew down there. So Isaac and Harry are her children, and Riley is one of my other cousins, Jack's sister's son. So hello to you boys. They were the ones that actually introduced me to the Pig the Pug books the first time they come out. I don't know if you've seen them in the UK, Claire, but they're kids' books, but they are absolutely fantastic. And it's all about my girlfriend has all of them, but she calls Pig an a-hole. There are no children watching this show, hopefully, so they won't figure out what I was actually just saying. So hello to Joanne and to Willow. Hello, hello. Oh, and yes, Kim, Rabbitohs. I was so the Panthers and the Rabbitohs are playing next weekend. So awesome. And, of course, we've also got I think it's Daylight Saving starts next weekend as well. Thank God.
Yay!
Thank God. Cannot wait. I'm so jealous because you've been telling me about all the lovely weather you've been having and we've had none.
We've been so lucky. Even today it's glorious and it's like the end of September, which is unknown. But normally at this time of year it's chucking it down and blowing a gale and we've been very lucky this year.
I am very, very jealous. Very jealous.
Like, so it follows you to the southern hemisphere and you get a superb summer and spring.
You need to. You definitely need to bring it. Send us some this way. And I've just realised I'm trying to sort two things out at once. What am I doing? This is what I get for. Aha! There it is. Now it's popped up. I've got to have two screens. I've got my screen to talk to you, and then I've got the screen to make sure that everything's going through live properly. Because as some of our long-term viewers know, at times technology gets the best of me. So tell us a little bit about yourself, Teddy and Doug, and how you all met, because it's a wonderful story.
Right, okay. So I'm a nurse with two children, and my husband, obviously, just as we were a family. And at 16, my son, who's now 22, turns around after his exams. He got some good results and he said, "I want a pug." And we were like, don't think so. Should we get a pug? Should we get one? Did some research into pugs and whatnot. And my husband's like, "No, I think we'll have a shih tzu." And then on Channel 4, they do a breakfast show. And there was a grumble of pugs on the breakfast show. And they were so hilarious and so cute and so just adorable. My husband went, "Get him a pug." Get him a pug. And do you know sometimes how the universal laws work and it's just meant to be?
Yes.
I rang this breeder that's literally 5 minutes away and she said, "Oh, I've got two puppies, you can come and see them tonight." So off we went. This is Doug and his mum and his sister Poppy. And they were just like two nutters running around like mad. And we decided we'd have Doug, and I said to the breeder, "So we'll pick him up on Sunday." And she went, "Oh, no, you can take him now." And just piled us up with a bag of food and a blanket, and that was it. Off you go. Of course, it's a Sunday evening, and Pets at Home isn't open. Everything's shut, and I can't get anything. But do you know what? It was the sweetest thing. He cuddled into my son, and he just slept all night on the chair with him. They sat up, the pair of them, just looking at each other. Then from that, it was just, the pug just took over. It's like, the pug is not allowed on the sofa. The pug is not allowed on the bed. The pug is not allowed to beg for food. the pug has to follow the rules. And Doug just went, "Yeah, no. I'm on the bed. I'm eating your food. I'll do exactly what I want because you are my humans."
Me.
And you can see from the...
Yes, I was just about to say that he's just incredible. It's like, give me a belly rub.
Yeah, he just doesn't care and he's just the centre of attention. And everybody loves him, don't they? Everybody loves you. Oh, yeah,
you can't see his face, but he looks very happy.
So we'd had him for 2 years. He was about 18 months old when my neighbours at the caravan moved. We have a caravan in Wales. And they were moving off. I was like, "Oh, wonder who we're going to get as neighbours. Oh, I hope it's going to be okay." And this Friday night, we turned up at the caravan and Doug's all agitated. And we're like, "What's up with the dog?" And as we got out of the car, on their decking were two pugs. And we were like, "Oh, my God, they've got pugs." And they were like, "Oh, my God, they've got a pug." And it was like love at first sight for Doug and Maisie. She was another farm girl.
Yeah.
And it was, they just bonded so completely. Maisie used to come and she'd scamper up the steps to my caravan. And on a Sunday morning, she'd be like, and she'd be knocking on the door because she knew I was cooking sausages. And she knew
of course.
So they used to run around like two idiots in our caravan. She'd knock on the door. It was just a dream. It was like pug heaven. And we were like, and then Sharon and Matt decided that they were going to breed their black pug, who was two at the time. She said, can we breed Doug and Holly? I was like, "Let's have a go then, why not, you know?" And Doug was like, "I know there's something wrong with you, but I don't know what I'm going to do. I'll just lick your ear." And he was just completely obsessed with Holly's ear. He didn't want to know anything else. So unfortunately, Sharon ended up having to pay to get him covered. And then a few months later, it was like we were asleep in the caravan and I got, "Ping, we've had a pup. Ping, we've got another one. Ping, ping, ping." One's passed away. And I was like, oh no, one of the puppies has passed away. Oh my God, this is 3 o'clock in the morning. And then they'd had 9 pups. Then I got another text message. We've revived the one that's passed away. So Matt had literally rubbed and rubbed and rubbed this puppy and brought him back to life. So it was like, I believe it or not, when he was little, he had a cross on his head like a donkey. And it was just like, this puppy's like amazing. And he could sit in the palm of your hand, and they hand fed him night and day for 2 weeks. It's just unbelievable that this puppy survived. So Matt called him Jürgen after Jürgen Klopp, who is the Liverpool football manager. And obviously Matt's got a special attachment to this pug now at this point. And Sharon was like, you know, you can have one of the pugs. And I was like, no, we can't just have a pug. She's like, yeah, you can have one of the babies. And I was like, she said, if you have Teddy, then we can see him. Because obviously having girl dogs, it's not compatible, is it? But we sort of made this unconscious decision that Teddy would come and live with us. My husband's going, no more pugs, no more pugs, not another one, no more pugs. So at the weekends when they came to the caravan, we would bring Teddy into the caravan and perhaps another one or two puppies. And my husband's like, oh, they're so cute. Oh, they're cute. and then Teddy used to sit down my top there, like a little warming mechanism that I was. And he'd go to sleep and he'd get some rest back, and then he'd eat and then he'd go back. And then he started staying overnight in the caravan. And then in the May time, I said, oh, we're taking Teddy home tonight. And he just looked at me and went, oh. So they became like bonded immediately. It was just unbelievable how well they got on. We put them in the back garden so that he would think he'd found him, if that makes sense. Yes. Just completely worked. He was like, why are you here? He went, oh, come on, and he showed him around, and it was just so sweet. But that's the story of Teddy and Doug's transition into the Wright family. But I would never be without a pug, even though my husband says the two for me and hairy.
Yeah. We all know what pug is like. Well, I was going to say, we're suffering the spring shed at the moment, so it is it's incessant. It's like Kim saying, two peas in a pod. At the moment, they do look it like.
I mean, can you believe that? Like, when I was speaking to you first, they wouldn't sit still and they were shouting all the time, weren't they? And then they're just like,
Oh, because what time is it where you are?
Now, past 10 in the morning.
Oh, well, it is still morning, snappy, sneezy time.
They just sleep. They're like two sloths, honestly.
Oh, poor things.
It's time to perform. Yeah, so, and then obviously we found out that Teddy could sing because my husband, Matt and Jake, watched Liverpool rugby, Liverpool football. When the crowd started to sing You'll Never Walk Alone, which is a Liverpool song.
Yeah.
Teddy's a Liverpoolian. He was born in Liverpool, which is 20 minutes down the road from us. He just started to howl at this song, didn't he? And he was like, oh, what's going on? And he was like, oh, no, it was just a fluke. But every time the crowd started to sing, he would howl along with them. And it was like, he knows he's scared. It's crazy. And then we thought, well, does he sing anything else? You put a song on your phone and he would not have any reaction to it. And then opera came on and he was literally howling to the opera. And he'll go, and it's so cute, so funny.
But he loves the songs. Are we going to try and see? I was going to say, Kim's just saying that she's loves the snoring.
Well, you know, you have to get used to the snoring.
There's always one puggy that snores more than the other.
Oh.
Oh my God, I cannot say that name. Singing SOS on World's Greatest. Apparently it's amazing. So you might have to give him a go. Kim said that was just brilliant. And I just said it.
Thank you. We think he's funny. just that you can put anything else on and he's just like not bothered. And then I mean, you saw how fast asleep he was, and then
And then it got, as I said, just as we were getting to the crescendo, he was like, "I'm catching up, and I'm going there." That was just amazing.
It's that he does that makes me. And then you sometimes join in, don't you? You do.
Hey, you didn't want to steal Teddy's thunder tonight, though.
No.
No, definitely not want to do that. Certainly makes some good lockdown fun. Completely agree with Kim there.
Total entertainment. Well, I mean, having a pug is total entertainment, full stop, isn't it?
Absolutely.
There's not many dull moments, is there? even if they're asleep, they're on you at some point. There's got to be a part of a pug touching.
Oh, absolutely. Or if one's, like, taking up all the space, the other one has to be over the top of the other one to at least get a head or a paw. That's my other one. Lynn was just – Lynn's falling in love with the head tilt.
What is it? Can it be that?
I'm going to say. Are you talking about me?
Yeah.
Well, I was going to say, Teddy's tail's going 10 to a dozen, so he's feeling invigorated after that singing match.
This pug never stops wagging its tail, honestly. It's the happiest pug. Right, so there was another story. Post Teddy coming home, he took a bit of chicken, and the chicken must have been that big, and this dog was like half the size of the chicken, and he just swallowed the chicken piece in one go, and he just went bang and just stopped breathing, and we were like, anyway, get the chicken out the dog, like, and then he's just like, and he just carries on with his tail. He's got nine lines. He's like a cat, honestly. He poked a hole through his eye in the garden on a branch of a tree. And we were like, oh my God, he's going to lose his eye. He's just like, he was fine after like 3 days of vet treatment. He's absolutely crazy.
Yeah. Oh, got to live the life to the fullest. He almost lost it.
Exactly. I think that's the motto.
And he eats pills.
Oh, yeah, he's eating one of my husband's aspirins. We had to take him to the vets, and they had to give him a stomach thing that made him sick.
Oh.
Completely wagging his tail all the time he was at the vets. He's absolutely...
All the vets were really confused.
They were like, why is he wagging his tail? He's vomiting. But he's just like the most loving little thing, aren't you? Oh, I mean, pugs are loving anyway, but he is just like crazy, aren't you?
Back to sleep.
He's gone back to sleep.
Yes, because, you know, we've after all of that singing, you've got to rest and relax. And
I've done my bit, Mum. Stop it.
Yes. Yeah. Doug, you know, Doug's turned to shine again.
Yeah. Come on, Dougie Pugley.
Wow, Puggies. I'm loving this episode, and I hope you are too. If you haven't already subscribed to our newsletter, then please click on the link in our show notes so you get advance notice of our next guest. And don't forget to join our Facebook group, Living the Pug Life, so you can be the crazy pug lady you've always wanted to be with our other like-minded crazy pug ladies. Now it's time to get back to the show.
So what's their favourite adventure?
They love going to the caravan, to the seaside. That's what they like best.
Yeah.
If you get the cane jokes, they're going to the caravan, they're in it before you've got it in the car. So they know, they're not daft, are they, you know? they do like walking on the beach. And Ted will swim with Zara, but Doug will just paddle. But I've said to you, we're going to get some...
get some life jackets so we can go for a deeper swim, absolutely. I actually I pulled out Rosie's and Charles. They're just over my shoulder over there, ready for this year, in the hope that they'll go a little bit deeper than Paul.
yeah. Well, I think it's the head thing. It's because the head's heavy, isn't it? And the brackets are phallic.
Yeah.
So I think if we get the live beach, they'll love it.
Yes. And if they already love the beach, then it's just... So good. Both of those heads, they know those key words.
Yeah, they love it. They just love it. I don't love the dog smell when they come back into the caravan and you've got to shut them off. it's great. They like any type of walk, but not too far, and certainly not in the rain.
Yes. I was going to say, do they have raincoats? Even though my two, even with raincoats on, they still look at me as though I've got rocks in my head that I'm suggesting that they go out in it.
They won't wear clothing. They love the harnesses, as I said to you. They've got some trendy harnesses. But we did try and put them in a jumper and they were like, get it off. So I bought Sharon's pug a jumper because my boys wouldn't wear one. So it was like, I like this jumper.
At least it went to a good home.
Yeah. Oh, God, yeah. Yeah, definitely. So the plan is to buy them both a bow tie off yourself.
Oh, yes. Get the cartoon ones.
Oh.
They're cartoony ones, but yes.
I've lost you, Donna.
Oh, have you? I can still hear you.
Right, okay. My back.
Right back. Gold. I have to admit, a couple of people have said early on that the line was a bit dodgy. So, but we seem to be okay now. So there's nothing. We were talking about this before we went live. I said there's always the chance that something will go wrong. And worst case scenario, I can sing myself since Rosie and Charles have ditched me.
So we're going to get bow ties and then I'm going to do a photo shoot with the bow ties.
They'll look very dapper. I was going to say that maybe a formal bow tie for when Teddy sings.
Yes.
So.
Yes.
Yes, I know. Like, you do need, like, the proper black bow tie for such events, I should say. Pavarotti is going to be knocking on the door soon, by all means.
Britain's Got Talent
No, no, you're quite all right. I was going to say I was just checking my notes from when we caught up a couple of weeks ago, and there was one thing that did catch my eye. You described the way that Teddy and Doug smell in the mornings so uniquely. I thought you've got to share it with everyone else because I am intrigued to see if anybody else has this same thought.
Right. So the pugs sleep, one with my daughter, one with my son, or both with my daughter. And when you open the room in the morning, it smells like Doritos, like plain Doritos. If you have Doritos in Australia,
yes,
it's just like when you've opened a bag of that stale, musty, crispy smell. It's just very strange. Please, Doritos, don't sue me for saying that. But it's a very strange smell. But it's like pug sweat. And it smells of Dorito chips. It's just weird. Yes, you do.
Well, people say things about newborn babies having that particular smell. I think you've, here we go. So I can't see if you can see the comments, but I'm just about to, I'm popping up Elvie's because apparently Jack's feet smell like corn chips.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
That's it.
Just sold. Absolutely sold.
It's a pug thing.
Yes, I have to admit, I've never been able to name the smell. So
you
definitely
in a bag of Doritos and go, oh yeah, that's it. Obviously, mom's just the plain chips. It's very strange.
I did forget to ask if it was the plain chips or if it was the cheese Doritos.
No, it's definitely the plain ones, isn't it?
Yeah. Lynn says, apparently she's in agreement with you. Gerald smells like Doritos too.
There you go.
Yep. Maybe we need to actually tell Doritos that they could very well be marketing Doritos to the wrong people.
Yeah.
They need to be doing it. Oh, apparently it depends on what day. He smells like Doritos. I mean, I'm not sure I want to know what days he doesn't, what he does smell like when he's not on Doritos.
we've got two problems. That there's Dorito smell and fish breath. Yeah, definitely fish breath. It's like thin salmon. And it's disgusting. apparently it's the food we put. They're on Royal Canin food.
Yeah.
And they're on dry food, as well as obviously the treats that they get from the humans. And apparently it's the high meat content in the Royal Canin. What can you do? We put up with you, don't we?
Oh,
Yes, because you bought it from. Yes.
Very much so. Well, apparently Lynn has said that some days it smells like the plain Doritos and other days Gerald smells like the cheese ones. So.
Oh, nice. Gerald's a fabulous name for a pug.
He's a pugalier, but he's more cavalier than pug.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, but in behaviour, so pug. So pug. So we... Oh, dearie me. So poor old Oscar, and I will caveat that Oscar is the senior pug out of our playgroup. So apparently his breath smells like a million-year-old nappy washed up on the beach.
Oh, bless him.
But he's beautiful because he's so old, and I have to admit Charles is sort of getting as old, that Lynn carries him everywhere. So... I think he's well and truly got it down pat. At least Gerald's the sort of pug that does love to run everywhere, everywhere. So, Gerald does look good in a necktie.
Yeah,
I will say that. So, yes, that's one thing I can say. Oscar looks good in a leather jacket, so I will say.
Oh, really?
But for a pug who gets carried everywhere these days, I don't think he can technically pull off saying that he's a bit of a... a rule breaker, noting that he's wearing, he's a very lucky pug.
Oh, that's amazing.
And I was just amazed. So Doug, he's had surgery on his hip. Just Ted's the mountain goat, but Doug's the klutz.
We'd have Doug about 6 months, and we used to take him every month to the vets for a weight check to make sure he wasn't getting fat.
Yeah.
And a health check. And he didn't pick up on that he had entropion, you know, where the eyelids fold in and it scratches the eyes. Mm. So by 8 months old, he was having entropion surgery. So obviously that costs an arm and a leg, doesn't it? But he had to take some of the folds of skin away and whatnot. And he's better. But it has left a bit of scarring on his eye, unfortunately. And then it was 2 years ago, he started to limp. And we were like, what's up with him? And because he's my husband's baby. Because he's my husband's baby. My daughter left the room, sorry. My husband was like, take him to the vets. And this dog has cost us millions. And the vet was like, there's something wrong with his knee and his hip. So he ended up having pins and plates in his knee and his hip to the tune of £1,500, which is a lot. You know? But the recovery, nobody can prepare you for recovery from a hip, knee operation with a dog. They're not allowed to put the foot on the floor.
No.
So you have to fashion a sling from a jute bag.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to cut it and shape it to pug size.
The pug size, yes.
Carry the dog to the garden, let it do what it needs to do, and then come out. And he's like getting up to move, and you're like, no, you've got to stay still.
No!
And then the U Move tablets that they give you are about that big.
Well, yes.
But. You know this old tale that give a dog a pill in cheese? This one will eat all the cheese and spit the pill out.
Yeah.
So any tips for pill giving, I would gladly take the tips because he doesn't like his pills.
No, you know? I've always had a lie. So Winston, out of my four pugs, Winston was never difficult to give pills to, no matter how big or small they were. Just because he was such a gannet that by the time he realised it was a pill, it was too late. Like it was
done. Love it.
So as long as it resembled something close to like a treat, then I was so excited.
He's that crafty that he just goes,
yeah.
And then all of a sudden the pill comes out and you think, ah. So like we tried cheese and obviously that he got wise to the cheese. So then I was wrapping it in ham, and that worked for a couple of times, and then he thought, oh, I'm wise to that now. And then, you know, well, what do you wrap it in?
Yeah. I've heard peanut butter works well.
Really?
Yeah, so the... But I've, generally speaking, most of the pills that I've had to give the pugs over the years, I've been able to cut up and put into their food. Yeah. So I've gotten around it that way, but... Rosie, when we got her last year, and sort of she's eight now, but she was seven then, so quite an older pug. And her previous family didn't give us a lot of her health history. And so at one point in time, we'd figured out that she used to vomit all the time, and it like was really distressing for her and distressing for us. And so we realised that she got acid reflux, and at times she gets hiccups. So if we catch the hiccups quick enough, then we're okay. But so we had to give them the human Nexium tablets for acid reflux. Yeah. Those bad boys are huge.
They're massive.
Yes. And you can't cut them up. You have to swallow them whole. And so I'm like, wow, I am going to be the most hated human in this house for the next 2 weeks while we get this sorted. Because you've got to shove them down. And I'd find bits of spit up all over them, and she got really inventive as to where she'd spit it up. And I thought, you little cow, I'd find them days later.
Under the fringe where she's putting with a pole.
Yes. I literally found them under their bed.
They probably dig and took it under there. What are you doing? I don't know if anybody else has this. You know, dogs obviously sniff when they're walking, and that's what they do, isn't it? They sniff.
Yeah.
And if he's gone near somebody else's pee, his face shakes.
Oh wow!
Honestly, it's as if he's like high on dog pee. It's gross, honestly. It's quite hilarious to watch. Even his head like twitches. It's like, what's wrong with you? But we wouldn't change it.
No. How could you say no to that face?
You can't.
No.
He's cute.
Oh, well, thank you so much for joining us today, tonight, this morning.
I'm sorry about the first time.
No, it's quite all right. Absolutely all right. And the upside is we still got to talk to you, yes. Most importantly, and we got to hear Teddy sing because, let's face it, Teddy's adoring fans. We're waiting. Thank you very much for listening to this week's episode of the Pug Life Show. If you liked the episode or if you think it'll be useful for someone else, please leave a review over at podchaser.com. And if you've got any questions or want to tell us how much you loved the episode, then let me know over at our Facebook group, Living the Pug Life. We're crazy pug ladies, meet to talk all things pug. So until next time, puggies, have a pawsome week, and humans, be generous with the snackies.